Welcome everybody to the Samsung 500 here at Texas Motor Speedway. Dave Blaney qualified in the top 10, P8. I had to make a couple adjustments to the car. Well, one adjustment, we started practice way too tight. Couldn't make a corner. So I made a slight adjustment to loosen it up a little bit. And I think we have a pretty fast car. And looking forward to getting this race going. It's going to be a long one, I believe 84 laps. Hopefully we can stay out of trouble here at Old Texas Motor Speedway. A lot of guys in the back, like Johnson, Gordon, Kurt Busch, Tony Stewart, and Reed Sorensen is last place. So with that being said, there we go. And we also have to deal with Brian Vickers, who tried to wreck us, but Blaney has to be feeling pretty good. He's won two races in a row, he's retaken the point lead, and he's also extended his point lead a little bit. See if he can go for three in a row. Oh man! Well, that's not going to go for three in a row, and that's not staying out of trouble. Everyone was pretty aggressive entering three and four. I believe we had Sadler to our inside dive bombing. Sadler was going to move us up the track regardless. So we don't even get a lap in, and we're under caution. Sandler, alright, back onto our bumper, Evelyn. It's not a short track, Sandler, get it in your head. Pinch this dive bomb. Pinch Schrader, I am sorry. Dirt guys and Blaney and Schrader. Blaney kind of washed up the track in 3 and 4. How about Junebug? Contact with Schrader again. That's heavy contact. Wow. Schrader and Martin, or Schrader and Biffle. But the 21 and 22 make heavy contact again. He just shut up. That time, he just shut up. So everyone's got their work cut out for him to catch the top five and the rest of the pack. But Blaney, he felt like he had a good car. Then he got contact with the 21 two times. For one of the 21 cars. And they also had Elliot Sadler breathing down his ass the entire time. Blaney's got a fast car. He's probably not handling the best right now. But how about, before that second time I was going to talk about, Bill Jr. could have his best race of the year right now. He's P6, just outside the top 5, and he got passed by Robbie Gordon. He's trying to get back into the top 5. The car's back to tight. Wonder if that was why we made contact so many times. Golan continues to lead. Wood stays third. but Junior, who's had a horrendous start to the year, pretty much in the first, like, half of the race of every race he's been in, he's been in the back. He's in the front now. He's yet to lead, I do believe, as well. And right now the top three are pulling away from fourth and fifth. We're slowly catching Schrader for six, or Sadler for six. With that heavy contact Schrader had with Biffle, I'm surprised we haven't gotten a debris caution. With the way the car is handling, I would not be mad to pit early to make an adjustment. Burley's good at solo car speed out of the 22. He actually might be getting a little bit of a rhythm with this tight car. Sadler is not going to make it easy on Blaney. Blaney wants to cut to the inside and his car just will not continue to turn off the corner. Staying off the gas. Sadler just flat out mirror driving, putting his bumper all over the nose. All that dirty air all over the nose at the 22, and finally a caution. And if it was not going to be a debris caution for Ken Schrader, it was probably going to be Sadler getting turned. So we're going to take an early pit stop. Everyone's going to go for one, we're going to go for two. We need a little bit of an adjustment here. Blaney's just in the top five on speed or fast laps. Wood, wow, fastest right now. Wood going and Vickers, 1, 2, 3. They're the top three of the fastest on the charts as well. This is also your points coming in.
Nobody else decided to come in.
Schrader and Biffle did not choose to come in and try to repair that damage they had on their cars. Blaney says, I need a little bit freer perhaps. Quick caution, we're going to jump way to the outside just in case that's going to be another debris caution. The debris cautions will help us. This time it's Greg the Biffle. Because we won't have to stay on pit road longer for gas. Two debris cautions on the day. Outside of JJ Yaley. Wow, just did not turn it 3 and 4 at all. We went right to the wall. We did not touch it, we stayed off of it. Oh man, Yaley. I really thought he was gonna turn off our nose. Sterling Marlin back here? Oh, big checkup! Holy cow! Hi, Montoya, hi! Did you cause that checkup for no reason? Just to say hi? I mean, I appreciate it. Sadly, I don't think it was.
Keep it together and stay focused.
Vickers now to the lead. Stewart trying to push Kyle Busch. Kyle and Kurt Busch kind of playing chicken. Kurt Busch might be having some problems here. Blaney, oh, and around goes Kurt. We were there, he just turned off of us. Caution number three. I mean, he just flat out wrecked himself. We were clearly to the inside of him. Kurt's not happy. Well, I'm not happy that you wanted to turn off the turn yourself off of us. Okay. I guess it's just going to be a caution fest. Again, clearly to the inside. I mean, good God. What is that, caution number four? Time we washed up the track, we were able to keep it off of Mikey. Who was that silver car? Marlin's in the 14. Who was in that silver car that I thought was Sterling Marlin? Oh man, Rudiman, big checkup off of 3 and 4, trying to pass Sterling Marlin. Kent Schrader racing well with the damage, so is Biffle. Rudiman continues to move in front of the 22. 22 overran the corner. Oh boy. I was able to get out the gas because I was not sure what Rudiman was going to do there. That would have been like another time that somebody's just flat out turned off our nose. I do miss the Domino's Pizza car being in NASCAR though. That was like a really good paint scheme. David Reagan also had some really nice paint schemes. Couple of spots out of top 10. Jimmy Johnson, he's also like been in the back most of the races this year. If I had to guess, David Gowen's gonna get the most bonus points unless somebody can retake the lead. Goodness. Not gonna force it. Martin really wanted to be the next caution by coming down on our nose. Good God, John Wood, hold your line. Hold your line. Garrett Sandler to the lead. We're back into the top 10, and we got Big Run on the bottom. Oh, it's got Riggs. It kind of overdrove three and four there. Jeff Green hooks Dave Blaney into the wall in 1 and 2. Caution number 4. I was going to say, I was going to be patient with Vickers and try to wait till he went on pit road for his pit stop. Everyone's going to come down pit road this time. Blaney is out of the top 10 on speed. He's yet to lead today. Kurt Busch, top 10, despite wrecking himself off of us. It's been a rough Texas race for Dave Blaney. He gets a really good pit stop. Puts him in the top 5. He didn't have to sit on pit road for gas. He just wanted the fresh tires. David Reagan also had a really good pit stop. We know this 21 has a pretty fast car, and he's not too thrilled with Babe. Can't really abuse your tires. It's still a long run to the end. Wood's gonna get Big Run on the 7 with the 22 in tow. This is the closest Blaney has been to the front in a while. His pit crew just delivered a big time pit stop. Jeff Gordon all the way in the back. Here comes John Wood with Blaney pushing him to the lead. Blaney also ran his fastest lap of the race. And I'm pretty sure he may want to just pull away with Wood and try to make it a 2-1-on-1. If they could leave this 19 in the dust. Because they top 30 kind of separated from Robbie Gordon. Another fast lap for Blaney, his fastest on the weekend. Top 30 stay pretty much nose to tail. Blaney looking for 3 in a row. He's been in a lot of contact, and today here at Texas, it's not been a perfect race for the 22. Sadler had a moment off of 3 and 4 that allowed the 21 and 22 to gap him a little bit. Blaney just cannot really get out the corner. Blaney's looking to the inside of the 21. Wildwood chopped his nose there in the corner. He's there. Blaney has a run. He doesn't want to make the pass on the 21 to the outside down the back stretch. That's going to be in the memory bank of John Wood right there. If Blaney gets a run, where is he going to go? Blaney shoots to the outside again. Wood up to block. As the top two start to separate from third. Blaney into the wall off of 1 and 2. I mean, Wood is also putting a lot of dirty air on that 22. Also, Junior P20. Good start to the race, may not be a good finish for that number 8. But also could be promising. Blaney, look to the inside, gonna get peek on the inside off exit. To the outside, Blaney. Contact a little bit, Wood. He's a young driver. Blaney has him looking around, mirror driving. Still a long ways to go. Mikey, another not great race. This is really going to hurt him after his fantastic start to the year. If he's going to be in contention for the championship, he's going to need a bounce back at Phoenix next week. And I believe Talladega. Blaney into the wall again off of 1 and 2. Sadler kind of sits alone. He has no help in front, no help behind. Again, was looking to the outside, looking to the inside, has the 21 moving around, keeping the 21 on his toes. Blaney's gonna get another good run off the corner. I think would rather Blaney pass him on the outside at the corner, contact entering. Blaney in the grass. Thank you. Oh, big contact with the leader. Both were able to save it. More contact on the day for Blaney. It's kind of been how he's gone in this Texas race. He was not trying to wreck Wood there, and they were just racing. Blaney was kind of getting tired of getting blocked. He wanted to get side by side. And he had a good enough run to put Wood on the outside of 1 and 2. John Wood was just being aggressive. And Wood honestly was lucky he didn't overcorrect and go right into the wall. Blaney, oh my goodness, I get so nervous. Had the run, Wood was gonna chop the nose regardless. John Wood does not want to give up the lead, even for a lap to the 22. Blaney to the outside, in 3 and 4, he was there. For a split second. Yeah, Still a long way to go. These guys are racing like they're coming up on the last lap. There's a slow car on the back stretch. Blaney to the outside. I believe that was Sterling Marlin. Blaney could get the run out the corner, looking to the inside. Blaney's there. He's there. Blaney lifted on. Loose. A huge aggressive side draft by John Wood. Blaney trying to push him up the track. Blaney looking for the lead. Wood did not get in 3 and 4 as at all. And contact. Wood turns the 22 into the wall. Blaney gets the 5 bonus points, but at what cost? I think we just saw the pass for the win, but the way these guys want to race. They left it all out, kind of on the line, just for a lap. Neither of these two really want the field to get caught out because they are putting on a show. The fans are up. Oh, man. Honestly, we got to get in our caution. We're going to come down pit road for tires. Because we still got a ways to go. And I would not mind a debris caution right now after getting turned into the wall. 20 to go at Texas. Blaney loop centering 1 and 2. And we wouldn't have enough time to get up here. Did Blaney rear out his tires early? Does he have enough fuel to get to the end? Is the question as well. Blaney drifting off the corner. Every time he does that, that's going to help the 21. Blaney's grip is gone. That's really helping the 21. A terrible 3 and 4 for Dave Blaney. Blaney's car struggled off exit all day. It's struggling a lot more now. Trying to put together some runs. Trying to get a little bit closer to the 21. We get under 10 to go, we don't want the caution. Because then no one's going to pit, and we might lose more than one spot. Blaney's caught back up to the 21. That clean air may have cooled his tires down a little bit, the little gap he had to make up. Blaney back to the bumper of wood, getting him the mirror race once again. Blaney's had a fast car, and Wood was not going to give Blaney any room off the corner. And this time John Wood has to give up the spot. Blaney moves up the ticket. The 22 for sure clear of the 21. Just a couple laps before 10 to go. Now can the young driver John Wood put something together on the veteran of Dave Blaney? Well, Blaney's going to miss 34. Oh, Blaney held him tight out the corner, as tight as he could. But Blaney was just too loose down the front stretch. Blaney got back to the inside and won a two. The tight side draft by Wood. They're back to racing each other, coming to 10 to go. Oh man! Wood got right to the corner panel and just turned Blaney. Blaney able to save him more content. This time Blaney into the wall. Wood turned him getting into the corner and just pretty much finished him off exiting the corner. John Wood is not racing clean. But you could also say the same thing that Blaney hasn't raced the cleanest. Blaney all the way to the top in 3 and 2, 3 and 4. Time to go now. That was hard racing with 11 to go between the 21 and the 22. Blaney's got core the tires down the best he can, put some runs together. But once again, what little grip he had on his tires, getting turned in a good corner and finished off, might not have been the best to help it. Blaney is just struggling now. He wants to get back to the 21. So loose. Blaney is not going to give up. He wants a 3 in a row. Gotta find a way, get some type of grip in his tire. And once he gets to the inside of Wood, with the way Wood has kind of raced him, I think he might use him up. Still a concern on the 22 team is, did they get the car full of fuel to get to the end? Both are pretty struggling for grip. This has been one of the longer runs on today without a caution. Blaney got to the inside. Blaney trying to pass the 21 clean. And Blaney to the lead. Can he protect it now? Did Wood use up his tire? Five more laps. Blaney's gonna miss one or two. Man, it is not easy hanging on. Wood maybe trying to cool off his tires for maybe a last lap run, last lap pass at Texas. He kind of seems to be fading. Blaney's not going to get the 10 bonus points. He's not going to lead many laps. But the only flag Blaney really cares about seeing would be that checkered flag, and he's seen it quite a few times already this year. Would let Blaney take the lead in case Blaney ran out of fuel. Was that another reason? Both these two are just trying to nurse their cars home. Neither of them handling the way they would like it. Two to go. If Wood's gonna make a run, he's gonna have to close the gap this lap, and he's got plenty of opportunity, Blaney, to knock off one or two. He doesn't have to push too hard to close the damn gap. Good God. Just find the grip. Find the damn grip and go. White flag at Texas for Dave Blaney. Can he hold on one more time around? Through 3 and 4 for the final time. Can Wood get close enough? Dave Blaney has won 3 in a row and he wins at Texas. My oh my. That last run was not easy. It was not a pretty race. Four days remaining, but a win is a win. And now we have the Phoenix with a lot of momentum. John Wood led the most laps. He led 31. Rakers led 11. Gilliland led 20. John Wood will get the 10 bonus points for the most laps led today at Texas. Jimmy Johnson finished in the top 10. Good for him. But now we can take another look at the point standings. I'm pretty sure we just increased it a little bit more, and Mikey's going to fall down the chart. $163 gap to Kenseth. Mikey falls to third. And the big day for the 10 bonus points for Wood puts him 14th on the year, just behind Elliott Sadler by 2 points. But 3 in a row for Blaney, and I'll see y'all next time.